Welcome to Take 5, a podcast brought to you by New Leaf Training and Development. Each edition is an inspiring interview with a leader worth listening to. Enjoy!
Hey, I'm Paul Butler. I'm one of the client partners at New Leaf Training and Development, and I'm so delighted to be joined by Cameron Smy today. And Cameron serves as the VP of State Government Affairs with Molina Healthcare. And also, can you believe it, he also serves as a council member for the City of Santa Clarita, which most of you probably know our office is based in, and gladly so for the last 17 years. But he's also served 4 years, all prior terms, as the mayor. Cameron, for nearly 17 years now, we focus on our core purpose of helping people and organisations better manage themselves, lead others and grow business acumen. I just wondered, what are your recommended best practices to help people and organisations be their best? But please do start, though, by telling us a little bit more about Molina and your work with the city, what you do and who you serve. So over to you, Cameron, and I'll wrap it up when you're done.
Well, thanks so much, Paul, and really appreciate the opportunity to join you this afternoon. So Molina Healthcare is a Medicaid managed care company that was founded here in Southern California in 1980 by an emergency room physician who saw too many people coming into the ER for their primary care, their colds, their backaches, their headaches. And you know, realizing that that is a very inefficient way to provide care, our founder, Dr. Molina, opened up the first of what we would call urgent cares in the South Bay area, Wilmington, California, to be specific. But what he did, which again seems very reasonable and common practice now, but in 1980, it was revolutionary. He hired people from the community, spoke the language of the neighborhood, and understood the specific health needs of those residents. And it really is one of those American success stories that what started out as truly a small brick and mortar clinic in Wilmington, 40 years later, we are now a nationwide company. We operate in 21 states. So I should say we're coast to coast, maybe not nationwide, but 21 states from California to Washington to Texas, Florida, New York, Wisconsin, Michigan. We have 15,000 plus employees, and we serve over 5 million Americans that utilize Molina through the Medicaid program. And, you know, what's important to us, you know, really is the company's driven values, and when you have a company as large as ours that like I said, 15,000 employees plus 5 million beneficiaries who rely on Molina, it really is important that we stick to our corporate values of integrity, right? Most of our funding is through government programs, and our members rely on government programs. So you have to have the integrity that when you're utilizing taxpayer dollars as your core, that you are being good stewards with that revenue, and it's being spent appropriately, particularly because you're dealing with people and their healthcare needs. You have to be accountable. Again, the same thing that we are for the most part are clients of our various states. We contract with the state to be one of their Medicaid providers, so we are always being reviewed and under review from the state and our state partners and regulators. So we are always having to be accountable, and we have to do it together. Teamwork. I'm sure most of the people you've spoken to all address the importance of teamwork. And you can't be stuck in your silos and isolating yourself and only focused on your issue. You have to work collaboratively and across lines of business to be successful. And open and honest communication. Again, when you're talking with people who are relying on you to help provide the health coverage needs and support for people when they're getting their treatments, and whether it be, you know, something as benign as, you know, just your regular annual checkup to, you know, much more important, or not important, but much more critical services, you know, like your pregnancy, you know, prenatal, postpartum care, surgeries, you know, transition into, you know, senior care. You have to be open and honest with your clients and beneficiaries, you know, as you're helping them navigate through those times in their life. And then finally, you know, member and community focused. Molina really takes a pride in, you know, being still you know, very driven and being a community based company. We have again a very robust foundation that works with nonprofits all across the country that support our members in a number of ways. And so, you know, those five values, I think, you know, can be applicable across the board to many industries. But that's what we have found that has helped Molina grow to, again, a company like where we are today, that I'm sure Dr. Molina never envisioned that his little clinic would be where we are, you know, today, 40 years later. And from a city perspective, I think there's a lot of what you've learned on the business side that, you know, that translates over. You know, Santa Clarita is the third largest city in Los Angeles County. We're pushing a quarter of a million people, you know, several $100 million budget. And similarly, you know, you have to operate your organization with integrity. You have to have teamwork. Certainly, I'm accountable. You know, every 4 years, the people of Santa Clarita get to review my job and my job performance and decide whether or not they want to send me back. And I think that, you know, there's nothing more accountable than an election. And I've always felt that, again, the importance of, you know, being open and honest with your constituents. You know, whether people agree with you or not, I think they do value and that, you know, honesty. You know, and if I can't get there on an issue, I always tell people that I can't, and the policy reasons why. Again, they may not like it, but at least they appreciate the, you know, the honesty. And then you always have to try to do your best to serve your constituency and you know, focus on the needs of the community as a whole, and use that to drive your decisions. So, you know, again, I think there's a lot of combination between you know, the private sector and what I do on the public side as well. But I really appreciate the time just to share a little bit about me and the values we have at Molina and how, you know, I apply those to my career at City Hall.
Cameron, thanks ever so much. And obviously, I mostly know you from your work with the city. And for someone that's lived here for all these years now, I'm just so grateful for the service that you and the other council members over the years have provided. We just love living here, as you well know. And then just a message out to the subscribers to keep an eye on the events page of our website for the events that we have going on throughout the course of the year. And then, Cameron, could I offer you a virtual high five?
We got it.
Thanks ever so much, Cameron, for all that you do.
Thanks, Paul. Appreciate it.
I hope you found that interview useful. And if you did, feel free to rate, review, and share this podcast. We'll be back next week with another episode, and we also invite you to check out our other weekly podcast, Going the Extra Mile, which is sure to lift your spirit and encourage you in today's working world. Bye for now.